Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about RPG plots. When setting up a roleplay group, unless you're running something explicitly plotless, you're going to need a plot. Even the most strictly canon of canon roleplays need a plot. Why? The plot is what's going to hook in your players. When looking for a roleplay group, the first thing we want to know is what the setting is so that we know if it's worth clicking that join button or going and reading the rules or whatever it is that we're going to do next in regard to looking at that roleplay group. So writing a good one is extremely important. I like to think of RPG plots like the back of a book. So you go into a bookstore, you start browsing through the books, you look at the covers, you pick one up and you flip it over, and you read that back of the book description. And that tells you if it's worth actually going and buying that book. Because a roleplay group's plot serves that same purpose as a book synopsis, you can use a lot of the advice people give out for writing a good book synopsis for writing a good RPG plot. So today we're going to talk about those RPG plots specifically, but if you would like more help on this, that's essentially what I would recommend, is looking up advice for writing book synopsises and imagining how you might apply that to a roleplay group plot. That being said, let's get into it. The first thing an RPG plot needs to do is set the status quo. You want your players coming in with the correct expectations. No one wants to join a roleplay group or spend a bunch of time reading a bunch of information only to find out that the roleplay isn't for them at all. Of course it happens, and it's fine when it happens, but we want to do our best to try to mitigate this. So that's essentially what the plot is doing. It's setting expectations so that people can understand if they should press forward. So ask yourself, what is the status quo of this roleplay? And put yourself in your player's shoes when you do this. You might have been working on this roleplay for days or weeks or months, but your players haven't. So when you're setting up the plot, lay everything out for them. Once you've done that step, I recommend sort of doing your first show this to a friend sort of thing. So show the plot to a friend, let them ask questions, and based on what they ask and what they say, fill in the details so that it clarifies things that your friend might have been confused on. And kind of keep doing this until the plot gives the actual impression that you want it to give. The next thing you need to consider is, does this roleplay have a hook? What is the conflict that the characters are trying to overcome? This is the thing that's going to make people say, "Oh, that sounds so cool, tell me more." So this needs to be clear and highlighted in your plot description. We also need to keep in mind that a plot should be relatively short. Again, think about the back of a book. It's a few paragraphs at most, and our plot should be the same. Prospective players should be able to skim over your plot and know if they want to read more or if they potentially want to join. We don't want to give them just a giant wall of text to read, because what that's going to ultimately do from your perspective as a mod is make it so that prospective players don't even read your plot and don't engage further with your roleplay to see if it would even be good for them. If you do run a longer form multi-para roleplay, consider in these cases having two plots. One that's a plot summary to hook people in, and then one that's the full plot that after people read the plot summary, they're expected to go read that. Because if they're a longer form multi-para role player, then if they like your plot summary, they're probably going to go read your tons and tons of words, you know, wall of text plot. It just shouldn't be the first thing that they read. Next, don't put everything into your plot. Your plot is there to hook and engage people and make them think about what kind of character they might want to make or inspire them to read further into the information on your roleplay or potentially join. So what you don't want to do is stifle players with so much information that they feel like they can't add to the story. Roleplay is collaborative, and your best players are going to want to help you shape that story. Once you've gotten to this point, go back and reread the first line of your plot. Does it grab potential players? If not, keep rewriting it until it does. People are busy. People have lots of things that they're trying to do. So a lot of times when people are looking through different roleplay ads, they'll read just the very beginning of the plot even before they decide if they're going to move on and look at the next roleplay. So you want to make sure that those first one or two lines really grabs the type of player that you're looking to attract to your roleplay. Now the last and most crucial step is to show your plot to others. You've at this point probably written and rewritten and rewritten and proofread and then rewritten some more, and at this point you can't really look at it and see it with fresh eyes and see where there might be issues in your plot. It's just not something that we can do. It's very hard to proofread your own writing. So what I would recommend doing is have all of your roleplay friends read the plot post and see if it's something that they would be interested in joining. If it's something that they wouldn't be, think about this. Think about if you really want to continue working on this roleplay, because what we've got here then is something where your closest friends aren't interested in it. If you can't attract roleplayers that you're already engaged with, then it's going to be really hard to attract strangers. So you need to then look critically at this roleplay if this happens to you. But if your friends are excited about it and they think it's cool and they're just offering a couple of tweaks, then press forward. You've got probably a really good roleplay on your hands that's going to go far. So what I'm going to do next is put the plot for my current roleplay up on the screen so that you guys can see how I've written it. So I'm going to give you guys a moment to read that. So it's not perfect, of course, and yours doesn't have to be either, but it does the things that it needs to do. The first two paragraphs set expectations. So without me really telling you anything else about this world, you know a few things. You know it's a post-apocalyptic fantasy, and you know that there's magic. Once we've established the world, then we introduce our player characters, the people from Erba Clan. And then we have our hook. Their settlement is relatively new compared to some neighboring clans, but they will defend their clan with all of their might. So if you join this roleplay, you can expect some fighting. This establishes everything you need to know and lets you know if it's worth your time to read more or consider joining. This is exactly what a plot should do. It should hook in the types of players that you're looking for to join your roleplay group. Do any of you guys currently struggle with writing plots? If you do, did this help y'all out? Let me know down below. Do you guys also have maybe other techniques that you use for writing your plot summaries for your roleplay groups? Remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching, and make it a great day.